What happened when you joined your first job after architecture graduation? Or your first internship? You might have felt a sense of unease, like you don't have the right skills for the job, or that there was a huge gap between what you were taught in school versus what was actually expected of you. Maybe you also felt like you weren't the right fit for the firm or the job. There is a major divide between the tech-first skills the AEC industry demands right now and what students are taught in schools. Architecture schools are still stuck in outdated methods and techniques. So what is it that an architect is supposed to do when they find themselves in a situation of limited career growth, burnout, or career stagnation at their jobs? Are they supposed to just accept the circumstances? No, of course not. Certainly not. And the way out is upskilling. By the end of this video, you will have an excellent understanding of what it takes to be a successful architect today, or what you can do to take your existing talents to the next level. Most importantly, you will understand how to harness the power of upskilling to achieve better jobs, salaries, and exciting projects. Architecture is primarily a technical field, and like all technical fields, success here is dependent on how relevant your tech skill set is. Take any big firm, be it Zaha Hadid Architects, Bjarke Ingels Group, or Henning Larsen Architects. Even to qualify for their job opportunities, a candidate requires a strong technical skill set in BIM, computational design, and other in-demand digital skills. But these skills are not taught in most universities, and applying to Starkitect or even mid-tier firms becomes a distant dream for young professionals. Now, there are multiple things wrong with architecture colleges, and we have addressed all of these issues in another video. The link to it can be found in the description. But the thing to remember here is that where colleges fail, us architects have to take matters into our own hands. We are at a point in history that presents design challenges we have never seen before. Our current population is at 8 billion, and urbanization is a huge challenge across the world. Climate change and its consequences on housing, human and animal life are pointing to the need for sustainable solutions. Architects are expected to be at the core of solving these problems for humanity, and efficiency is crucial here. It needs to be facilitated with the latest technology. And this brings us to upskilling. Upskilling is the practice of continuous learning and skill development. It helps you by making sure you are consistently on track with the changing demands of the industry. It makes you job ready, but more importantly, it keeps you job ready. It enables you to achieve your career goals and your design goals. So how can architects upskill themselves? The first step is to measure your existing skills. What are the skills you want to build? And what skills do you already have? What are the areas you could master, and what does the industry demand? Secondly, prioritize your skill gaps and group similar skills together. For example, you may already know AutoCAD, so why not upskill to interoperable software such as Rhino and Revit? Explore new software picking up in the industry and go for areas that intrigue you, be it advanced parametric software or cool form finding designs. One of the best ways you can begin upskilling is by enrolling in online certification courses that teach these skills and to actively practice them. Of course, there are other ways to upskill too, including books and videos, but online learning has emerged as one of the best and most structured ways of upskilling. Every few years, conduct this exercise again. Analyze what you are missing and what you want. Map your path and figure out the best way to achieve your goal in a manner that is time-saving and allows the most growth. And then shortlist the certifications that will help you get there. Given how fast the world around us is changing, firms around the world are actively pushing for their employees to upskill. In fact, research from the World Economic Forum found that the half-life of any skill is now reduced to 5 years. This means that the skills you possess currently will be half as valuable 5 years from now. If architects do not invest their energies in continuous education to equip themselves with the latest skills every couple of years, they run the risk of not adding any value to the industry and becoming irrelevant to the profession. To ensure your relevance in the industry, you want to get ahead of that decline in value. The recognition and reputation you desire is in your hands. Upskilling is where that begins. Upskilling is the key to a successful and impactful architectural career. We hope this video gave you an idea of the benefits of upskilling and how it can help you accelerate your architecture career. To stay up to date with what's a buzz in the AEC industry, make sure you like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And we'll see you in the next video.